Yes.
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 Okay, good. Because last time we started the broadcast and then no one could hear me. Okay, great. So let's get started. For those of you who are watching online, this is the OpenWorm development meeting bi-weekly. Go to openworm.org to find out more about the project. We are working on some agenda and minutes. All those are publicly available for you to follow along with. If you like, just check out our website and go to our resources, and you'll find our shared folder, and you can find our meeting minutes over there. Okay, great. So with that preamble, hello, everybody. Let me, since I can't do the doc thing, let me do the screen sharing thing. I'll walk over the agenda. Okay, great. So, first order of business, Gleb. Gleb, can you pronounce your last name for everybody?
It's Gleb Kuznetsov.
Gleb Kuznetsov, welcome. So, I met Gleb through a connection of a professor that I worked with in college, who I did my master's degree with. So, Gleb, why don't you say a little bit about yourself?
Sure, yeah. So I did my master's with the same professor that Stephen did, so that's how we got put in touch. I've kind of been interested following along for the past year or so, but more recently, I was at Google for about a year and a half, and recently I got just pretty much tired of working on social media products, so I left and have now been exploring something totally new to do, so specifically something in the sciences. So this is an awesome launching point. Where I really hope to contribute and learn a lot.
Sweet. Awesome. And do you want to say a little bit about your sort of coding, hacking backgrounds?
Sure. So at Google, I did a lot of front-end development. So I did JavaScript development, and the server was all in Java. And I'm pretty strong in Python as well. So I'm happy to help out at any point. I also want to pick up some more like C-like skills. So I know we have some stuff in that area. So definitely not shying away from any part. And like I told Steven before, I've had trouble figuring out a good jumping in place just because there's a lot going on with the project. So if there's something like a pretty finite task, like that would be perfect if like you need someone to help out with that, especially for me as I start out. So I think that's a good way to get people to start out in general, give them a finite task, and just have them go from there until they can choose their own path.
Cool. Actually, I'll take a screen share off. Do you guys want to introduce yourselves real quick here, the ones who are in the room, just for Gleb, who doesn't know you guys? Mateo?
Yeah, okay. I was wondering if we all see each other in the same order.
Do we see each other in the same order?
So for me, it's Gleb, myself, Steven, yeah. Giovanni, Sergey, and Jamie.
Okay, yeah, that's the order I see, too. Okay.
Yeah, that's good. That was wondering, am I next?
Yes.
My name is Matteo. I'm a software engineer. I've been basically working as a software engineer for the past 6 years, something like that, anyway. And I joined the OpenWorm project, I think, since day one. It's like just out of interest for computational neuroscience, but like I was coming from the more geeky angle of artificial intelligence. Oh, cool things. And I got dragged down the road to actually doing proper neuroscience and building computational models for it. And I got interested and mainly worked so far on an architecture that we internally call the simulation engine. It's a very generic name and nothing that is meant to be sold or anything. And basically is the engine that we are planning to use in order to simulate the C. elegans for now. So like I have a document, a couple of presentation, and there is some stuff in the wiki too about the simulation engine itself, which outlines the main requirements for it, like why we're building it in the first place and what kind of feature we would like to have from it. So and that is been my my contribution so far, and obviously it's a huge thing, even if it's just two words, simulation engine, it's a huge thing, and so far has taken pretty much all of my time. I worked also on the OpenWorm browser, you might have seen it, along with Steven and Giovanni, which was also a nice achievement we achieved over the past month. And what, Joe?
I'm posting a link to that in the chat.
Yes. Built on open source Google technology.
yeah, built out of the what used to be the Google Buddy browser, then became the open source 3D viewer, whatever, and on with that. And that's pretty much, I'll keep it short so that everyone has a chance. That's pretty much it.
Yeah, he knows me, so we can go on to Giovanni.
Okay, so again, background, software engineering. I have a degree in electronic engineering, but ended up doing software, and then I have a master's degree in software engineering, and pretty much my professional career has been like 6 years software engineering. And again, I started working on the OpenWorm project from the beginning, or the other, and working mainly on the simulation engine as well. I guess I can hear this background noise. Can everybody hear that?
Yeah, Tim, are you? It kind of sounds like there's a prop engine behind you or something. Oh, okay. I think we got it. All right.
Okay, so I was saying, yeah, so mainly working on the simulation engine, and Matteo's been working more on the global architecture, like general architecture, while I've been working more in the guts of the thing in terms of running algorithms on the GPU or CPU using we are using OpenCL, and that I spent pretty much most of my time around that area. So basically, the way that the simulation engine is that there are solvers for different things, and they use GPUs or via OpenCL. So I've been focusing around that area. Lately, I've been looking at streaming via WebSockets and other stuff too. So the Worm browser as well. So pretty much any area that needs stuff to be done, I jump on it. I think in terms of, I'm very happy 2 years that GLAB has now time to help out, and I think there's definitely finite tasks that we can identify, and we have all sorts of stuff. So there's the OpenCL stuff, which is basically C code. Then there is, we have the WebGL front-end for the simulation engine that we are developing. Sergey is currently working on that. And then we have a Java server-side architecture that's supposed to be streaming to the front end. So there's a bit of everything. I'm 100% sure that we'll be able to find something that appeals to you in terms of what would you like to do, and just hopefully even after this meeting, we can like you can identify some areas you're interested in, and there are ways. I mean, whatever you're interested in, we'll find a way to put the structure around it. Same as we do for everybody else. So that's pretty much me. I'm working on the full stack, whatever gets done, whatever needs to be done, I basically jump on it and try to help out. That's pretty much everything.
Sergey?
Hi, Gleb. My name is Sergey. I'm a PhD student at the Institute of Information Systems at Novosibirsk. Area of my interest is artificial intelligent neural informatics, physics, and modeling of complex systems. So I work in project on the SPH, ETI SPH. It's a modeling of the liquid and elastic matter on the CPU, on the OpenCL, and so on. Also, I worked on the NeuroML model, and now I'm still working on it. So that's all, I think.
Hello, my name's Tim, and can you guys hear me okay?
There's still this weird, like, background noise, but I think we can. I think when you're talking, we can hear you fine.
Yeah, it's probably this crappy mic. But yeah, so anyway, I'm a computer scientist with a neuroscience background, and basically my focus has been on the neurons and those connections. That's what I've been working on.
Okay, perfect. Cool. Thanks for the introduction, guys.
Sure. So, and there's several folks who are out today. Some may pop in. I got another note from Borg saying he's not able to join. So, but I think maybe we'll have Andre a little bit later. We'll see.
Steven, can
yes?
I? Andre wrote me that he can't connect to this meeting.
Uh-oh. Okay.
So can we do something?
Let me send him another invite. See
okay.
If it changes.
Is that him?
I invited. That's me inviting.
That's the invite, yeah.
Re-inviting him. So let's see if that works. Otherwise, if we can get him on chat, let's see if that works. Okay. Vlad, didn't you work on Google Plus?
No longer.
Can we hold you responsible for anything that doesn't work now?
Not anymore.
No. Okay. All right. Oh, do I? Is that what that is? Oh, bother. No, it should be. It should be June 27th. The one I have is header June 27th. That's weird, actually. Somebody else is typing as if they're OpenWorm other than me.
I don't know why.
It's your chats are coming up as OpenWorm. Oh, maybe you're clicked into OpenWorm, actually.
Let me come back in as myself.
Okay. All right.